Welcome to Pro Se Legal School. We provide tools for you to do work. I'm Coach Neighbors, and in today's video, we're going to review the property tax package. Now, I've been updating this package to move it over to the expensive group. What my team decided to do, is we're going to leave the package the way it is over there, $600 package. The new package that we're making now is going to be the commercial package that's going to be included in the new online course that I'm putting together right now to protect your property from everything. Pretty much. So that's what we're doing with that. So, you know, this new documents that I'm talking about adding for the people that invested in the property tax package up to now, we'll get to new documents. I know, just kind of luck how to draw. But from now on, the documents that I'm talking about, the extra documents that I'm putting in that package are going to be in the package that we have in the online course for protecting your commercial property. So we'll talk more about that later. So I just want to make sure you understand the difference when you see the last document. The new document that I'm going to put in today is the offer to pay letter, and we'll talk a little bit about that later in a different video. But that offer to pay letter is going to be added to the commercial package, and the offer to pay letter is so badass. You can actually go to my YouTube channel and take a look at what it's about. So I'm going to do a screen share. Now, before we get started on all of this, I kind of want to touch on some things that probably everybody's thinking about. So who do you sue first? And how do you do all of that if you're in this property tax situation? So basically the way this plays out is generally you got two game plans for the property tax situation. Game plan one is when they've already attacked your property and they're about to push you off the cliff or do the eviction situation or whatever. Okay, now the other game plan is when you want to challenge that shit before you feel the heat. So, you know, it's two different game plans. Now, you know, the game plan could change depending on a bunch of different things, but not really them. So we're just going to talk about those two, and then you can figure out how this fits into your situation. Okay, so one of the first things I want to tell you guys, you know, when people have trouble with their lawsuit or whatever, it's usually because they don't have the right damn defendants on there. So we're going to talk about that for a second. So what defendants do you want to put on your lawsuit? Now, I'm going to be specific here just a tad bit, but I'm going to be evasive here on the back end of this, and I'll tell you why in a second. So just work with me here. Now, if I'm doing a foreclosure, if I'm stopping any kind of attack on my property, the very first people that I want to have as defendants, defendant number one, are these people right here, the Registered Deeds Association in your state. Oh, I found out about this a few months ago. I did not know there was a Register of Deeds Association. Now, let me explain to you why this is so valuable in this situation. In my opinion, the Register of Deeds Association is where they register your property at. Okay, so just slow down. Give me a second. Okay, so the state law mandates that when the property is sold, state transfer statutes mandate that deed is supposed to be delivered to your house, and it's not. They do what they call their constructive delivery, and they register that shit in their offices. And this is where they register it, in my opinion. This is like the beginning of that. Once they register in the office, they send your ass a copy. That registration allows the first illegal lien to be put on the property. Now, the first, we'll get to the property. Just work with me. You got to understand the whole stinking scheme here. First illegal lien was a property lien. It was the mortgage lien. And the reason it was illegal is think of it like this. The mere fact they accepted your signature on the alleged lien proof that you were the owner of the property, and I smell stink. Okay, so that's how they commit real estate deed fraud to get your deed in their office. After your deed's done, we're getting to the property tax right now. After the deed's put in these places, they reclassify your property to one of three designations: residential, commercial, or agricultural. Now, the city of Lawrence says they have 11 classifications. I didn't even want to look and see what the hell that shit is, okay? So once your property is reclassified, because it says in the Constitution, not once but twice, that private property is not to be taxed. So they commit real estate deed fraud, commandeer your deed in their shit. Then they reclassify your property to one of their declassified, and they register your shit all right here. Uh-huh. And now once it's reclassified, that allows them to start the property tax bullshit. Pretty much. I mean, I've walked this, I don't know. If anybody thinks, I don't know what I'm talking about, leave a comment. Leave a comment down there. But you're probably sitting in a comment until I'm done. I mean, I think I already know what the hell I'm talking about. But, you know, so this is the first people that I would be putting on. Oh, hell yeah. They'd be first on the list. And then you need to have a state on there. Yep. You need to have the state because state's paying these people. State is the one bankrolling all the shit. Mm-hmm. So you had the state. You had these people. And you know, you need to go through your paperwork and see who signed to get your shit in their office and stuff. Yeah, so that's how you kind of go about figuring out who you need to go after. You know, at the end of the day, then judicial foreclosures, they do a charge off and do all that stuff. And then I don't know how they can, how that shit gets over to the illegal collectors. Oh, right there. That's how it gets over to the third party debt collecting attorneys. Yep. And most people don't know that there's actually there's a lien against your property already. They got your deed registered in their office and they use that shit for collateral, for loans from the federal government, all kind of stuff that I don't understand. So let's just get on with why we came here today. Now, this is the property tax package. It says 2023. I updated it again. We're going to leave. Well, actually, I'm going to change this 2024. Five package. It's going to be the commercial package. So I'm trying to figure out a way to keep up with all this shit. So that's what we're going to do. And the commercial package is going to have all this stuff in it, but it's going to have a few extra things. So let's just stay focused here. Here we have the demand to strike is what you use if there's case against your property. Now remember, we don't run around trying to answer to them and respond to their crap. According to the Federal Rule of Civil Procedure, as long as you have defense, you ain't got to answer to none of their stuff. So what you get here is offense. These are punching offensive documents. The demand to strike, the judge's order, the attorney's stuff from the court record. You can strike. Oh, I love playing with that. This is totally off the chain. You're demanding to strike because they're not registered as foreign agents and they're violating Tucker's Act, and you're actually mentioning criminal liability in there. Now, I'm not going to go through these in order that I would file them, but we're just going to kind of go through the list here. And so this next one is the demand for sanctions. Now, this is one of the ones that I would probably consider filing first. This is like a mini lawsuit that you file inside of their shit that they have against your property. And basically, this one has been beefed up. The demand for sanction for mortgage fraud came from the mortgage fraud package. It's badass. This is like 3.5. You can put whatever $1 million you want on this demand for sanctions, like a mini lawsuit that you file in their shit without having to pay filing fees. And you want to file that before you demand to strike their shit. Because when you're demanding strike, you're demanding to throw all that shit out. You want to get this shit on the table and make them sweat. And then this is the 42 SC 9 foreclosure offensive lawsuit. I included this in the property tax package as I'm beefing up to step this package up to commercial. But I also wanted homeowners to use it because I have a hard time explaining the difference between tax lien foreclosure, judicial foreclosure, non-judicial foreclosure, HOA foreclosure. None of it matters. The difference matters if it has foreclosure on the end. But I just added this in this package so you can go after them for the tax problem, and then you can come back and sue them for the foreclosure problem. Or you can sue them for the foreclosure problem to stop the tax problem. Until you want to sue them for the tax problem. Okay, I just enclosed. So you get two lawsuits in this package. Well, actually three if you include the demand for sanctions, because it's like a mini lawsuit. Now, this is the 2022 legal malpractice lawsuit that I put together. And this I put together for people who got ripped off, who trusted an attorney to help you with this problem, and an attorney threw your ass under the bus. This is legal malpractice lawsuit, but it's not going after them for legal malpractice because... Well, it is sort of. Okay, let me explain. To go after for their kind of legal malpractice, you'd have to have a whole bunch of, the whole neighborhood of people have to die or something, or get injured, okay? Maybe not die, get injured. We'll go with injured. Okay, but here we're going after the attorney that you paid for breach contract. Bam! Mm-hmm. Breach contract. And you can prove the attorney breached the contract by the time they get done, by the time you, well, you know what I'm saying. Yo, this is the Challenge Property Tax Lawsuit, the actual lawsuit document, and I'm just going to open it up and show you the first page of it, because it's badass, okay? And I don't want people to think I don't know what we're talking about here. So here you go. I'm going in $3.5 million to complain for conspiracy to commit real estate deed fraud. Oh, that's so hot. Conspiracy to commit real estate deed fraud violation. Violation of section 241. 18 U.S.C. Code 242, deprivation of rights under the color of law, conspiracy against rights, and violation of IRS code. Yeah, almost too much from my mouth to say. So this lawsuit package has been beefed up to include the real estate deed fraud, and really, all you have to do, I mean, real estate deed fraud is basically what this is, what they're doing when they didn't deliver. So you don't even have to, all you have to do is just have real estate deed fraud in there and then show the elements of real estate deed fraud and then explain it in how, that's pretty, you guys can see that, there's like 42 factual allegations here. You guys can see that put a little work in that, puppy. So you're getting two for the price of one. Well, you know what? I'm very proud of my stuff. So this is the foreclosure document that's been beefed up. This don't look like the regular 42 USC one. yeah. And this is the document that's going to be in the mortgage fraud package. It's going to be, this one is going to be also in the online course. I got a couple extra things to put in there in the online course for the online course one. It's going to be. So you guys can see that you bring my stuff to the table, you need to have it right. Because you see, we ain't playing around here. And you bring this shit to the table and you don't have it right, they're gonna move your ass up on the list and do what they can to, So the civil cover sheet, it just has the answers, kind of basically. Now, you can't just go by these. You need to know this shit yourself. But this civil cover sheet will kind of help you out with those answers. That's what that is. And this is one of my signature, your demand to strike the attorney's notice of appearance. We got a few things to strike up in her. Now, this is a notice of claim for property tax, a lawsuit letter. The notice of claim for property tax lawsuit. This is a notice of claim letter, and it pretty much has the information out of the lawsuit in it, just structured a little bit in a letter format. This letter is also in a PDF in a Word format, so you can copy and paste it in a letterhead from. Now, this is for people who have time to fool around, you know, and you want to punch them in the face a few times before you bring your stuff to the table to get their respect. So the idea here is to not have to file the lawsuit. And you come to the table with the facts and shoving them up in their face. And hopefully, I mean, we had Nikki Ross, she helped some people get their deed delivered and they didn't even have to file a lawsuit. Now, this is a temporary stain in order to block federal funding according to the spending clause in the Constitution. This is what you were used to block the state from receiving federal funding because they're violating your due process and the Fifth Amendment. So that's pretty much how that looks when you invest in this package. So now I'm going to open each of and review the document. We're kind of going to do this in order that I would think about filing them if it was my case, okay? The first thing that I would probably want to stick in their face is a demand for sanctions. And you can see here that you need to replace the red font and whatever you're demanding here. And you should remember that when you're using my documents, we're not going after them for the individual things that most people think that what they need to talk about. We're going after them for the day-to-day procedures and processes they use to line you up in their administrative court. So let me make this a little bigger. So you can see here, you're going in and you're addressing the mortgage fraud here. And the federal statute shows that bank cannot lend the depositor's money. That's the statute right there. So if the bank can't lend the depositor's money, then how the hell? And you're going after them right the foreclosure statute does not have three elements necessary to show that it's a valid law. It's not. It's a statute. A foreclosure statute is not a valid law. So you can see here, all you have to do is just change the red font. Everything else is pretty much the same. So basically what you're saying here is the affidavit that they filed was junk. Judge has conflict of interest. Attorneys cannot testify. Fraud and deception on the court. So we're just going to scroll on down so you can see there's nothing really to change on there except the red font and personalizing it. Or that's a demand to strike the attorney. And then probably next, I would consider filing the demand to strike. And again here, you just replace the red font. It's pretty simple. And this was the affidavit. You just place the red font, put your name in there, your information. So you see, when you go after them for the procedures and processes that they use to violate you, then it's a whole different program. Now you don't have to worry about all these individual things. This is the foreclosure lawsuit. And again, you see, you just change the red font, put in whatever million that you want there, put your name in there. Everybody thinks they have to add a bunch of stuff and all of that. And all of those people end up calling me later, freaked out because they're, yeah. So the amount that you paid interest, you can take care of those grammar errors. And so basically, you're just going to turn this into, you're going to put what you need in here, not turn this into your stuff. I always tell people, you need to bring your stuff to our program. Don't try to take my program to your stuff, because their stuff is conventional. Our stuff's non-conventional. Big difference. And you have to be very careful mixing the two. These are the things that we talk about. So in this lawsuit package, you're saying there are six things that's missing from the contract that you and the bank signed, you and the lender signed. And one of those six things you're saying is missing, that the bank agreed, the lender agreed to do the deal according to the GAAP accounting principles. And they can't say they did. They can't, yeah, because they didn't. They, yeah, this is very powerful. Oh, right here. See, yep. According to the deal, according to the GAAP accounting principles and violation of federal law. They can't say to electronic credits. And these are all of the factual allegations. I break it down right here. The bank failed to disclose the promissory note is money or not money. it appears the bank recorded the promissory note as an unauthorized loan from a homeowner to the bank. The defendant committed and conspired to commit real estate deed fraud when they failed to deliver. Oh, dude, this is so badass. I'm just saying. So this kind of outlines the path that the illegal shit took. You just put your name in there, change the dates. And obviously, that would be something that you would want to change. So everything might not be marked in red, but if you understand what the hell we're doing here, you should be able to jump right in here and get this done in a very short amount of time. Very short amount of time. Oh, this is badass. So this is the same, the lawsuit that's in the mortgage fraud package is a little bit different, but they both, as you can see, the lender failed to follow the GAAP accounting principle laws. The contract should be rescinded because the attorney did not provide full disclosure. The contract is extremely deceptive this is some of my better work. These, if you decide you want to ask for for evidence. You put together your thing for asking for evidence. These are the records, the banking records that you need to show. Oh, yeah. That's this. Not very many people know this. These are the banking records that you should put in your demand for evidence. Or when you call them to ask what the hell's going on, tell them, I need these records. I need FR 2046 balance sheet. I need the 1099 OID report. You guys, and while you're pulling those, go ahead and get the S3A registration statement, the 424 B5 prospectus, and you might want to practice saying it before you call them. Yeah, tell them you need all that stuff. I'd write that stuff down too, and send it over. So you can see these are the counts. And when you state a claim, you have to have all the counts and connect all the parties to the counts. But what I usually do is when you claim, if you claim conspiracy, then it's not that big a deal, all the connecting. But here we got everybody connected just like they have. This whole package is done just like the attorneys want to do it. Except we got the bank ass on the hook. Oh, but we got the deal the way it went down for real. That's what we got right here. We got the deal the way it went down for real. And then we always have a little something in there about their conduct. And slander of title. Slander of credit. Affliction of emotional distress. Now we're down to the damages. And you can put in here whatever the hell you want to. You know, we went after my sister's case, the attorney's property. And so we had to add the attorney's wife to their attorney's foreclosure because she was a signer on the property, and we went after their property through a counterclaim. So we had to serve their wife the counterclaim. Yeah, it got a little ugly. Oh, they were really, our attorneys were really, really mad. Now, this is the statement my sister kind of put together about her losses and what she went through. And I highlighted all this in red so you could change it and make your story in here, what you went through at the hands of these fools, telling everybody all these lies and having people come to your house and having you worried that they're coming to throw your family out in the street. You know what I mean? And then here we address the fact the judge don't have no immunity for shit. And the five elements of due process, which none of them... The elements for forgery, making and altering, yeah, this is very powerful. And then your request for damages and your wherefore. Now, this is kind of jumped around on different pages, but when you do this, you'll have to move it around and set it up. And then these are some instructions that I put along with this. Now, this is the 5.5 million, like I said, that should be read there. And so you can change this. And this is the this is the lawsuit for the illegal property tax collection. Now, it don't really say property tax in there, but this is fire, and this is what I would use if it was my dad or family. So you see, all you gotta do, just change the red font, correct a few errors. See, it's not that hard. You don't need to add a bunch of stuff to it. You don't have to add nothing, hardly. Oh, there's his or her. His or her. And this is kind of what you're demanding, your remedy. You want your deed removed from the county recorder's office and all other information pertaining to your property. I heard now they have two fake documents. Well, one is real, which is the original one, and then they made another document that you have to get out of there. And then you want to make sure that all the debts are discharged against the property. And then here we go for the elements for conspiracy, the elements for real estate fraud. These are things that you have to have in, the elements for deprivation of rights, elements for IRS code, and the parties. So you can see here, if you're not in Kansas, that should be red. So you have to change that to your state. And then you can see how we have everybody connected here. And pretty much everybody is all on the same. Slander of title, slander, yep. So it's not that hard to put these together. This is a temporary restraining order to block federal funding as per the separation clause in the Constitution. And you can see it doesn't really require very much in the way of changing. And this is a reflection of going after them for the day-to-day process and procedures. Now, I don't see the affidavit of state citizenship in here, so I need to add that. Okay, so that's pretty much what the property tax package looks like, and I'm building a nuclear property tax for commercial, and we're going to have that in the new online course that we put together, the online course to protect your property, the legal property blaster. I don't know what we're going to call it. We're still working on that. Thank you guys for the value of sharing your time. If you have this problem, get what you need. Start punching them in the face.